Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, we're making it work, and I'm Jimmy. We're gonna do some serious work on this here Maxima 2011 with 117,000 miles on it. A little bit rusty too from up north. Some of you guys might be familiar with that. Rack and pinion's gonna get replaced. I already started soaking things down with a little bit of deep creep, and this thing's gonna be basically like a brand new car. We're done. Get my Capri thin wrench in there, stop that thing from turning. It's really weird that it's an 18 millimeter nut and a 19 millimeter hex on the back. I don't know why they can't make them both 18, but I guess I'm beating a dead horse. Just listen to that song. I forget the name of the band right now, but I actually know it. But it says, why do they always send the poor when it comes to war and stuff like that? So why do they always send the poor? Kind of makes me wonder. It's a volunteer military, so why do they send them? That's who volunteers, or is it really all poor? These are the kind of things I ponder while I'm working. Don't try this at home, kids. And if you're not real good with a hammer, put a nut on them threads so you don't mess them up. There you go. Not hard at all, really. Bring you guys in on the impact cam. Oh, that's nice. That ought to fit right out of there if my predictions are correct. All we need to do is get my chubby little fingers up in there. Oop. That is a thread all the way out. That's not right. It's a little bit crusty. Put it for safekeeping. We're getting close now. A couple of lines, some mounting bolts, and it should slide out apparently. You don't even have to lower the cradle on these, I believe. Sometimes when they're a little rusty, they don't want to come off. Cover your ears. That's about it. That's loose. Mess with me, you get messed with, or however that goes. The manufacturer told you to lower the exhaust on this, but not because you have to get the rack out, just because it's easier to get to the lines up here. See where those lines are? That clamp is a real booger. I couldn't hold the camera and I had to squeeze it with my hose clamp tool. My AU hose clamp tool on the left there. And then pry the hose off while I squeeze the clamp. And I couldn't, there was no place for the camera guys. Sorry if I couldn't film that. That was a little bit of a bugger because that clamp is about 5 times stronger than your usual squeeze clamp. Now the line, the 14 millimeter fitting underneath it for the pressure line is real easy. I just used an extension and impact, came right out. That's what that looks like right there. Now it's just the two main bolts, and they have nuts on the top. I believe it's 21 millimeter. And once those two bolts are out, the rack should slide out the driver's side with a little bit of dancing, of course, and holding your tongue right. Goes without saying. Look at that. Boom. Oh, that's very sharp in there, by the way. Oh, man. Is there one more bolt holding that some again? That's incredible feet engineering right there. That's cool, huh? They can't stop it from leaking, but they can sure make it fun to work on. Alright guys, Friday morning, making it happen. Got the rack out last night. I'm gonna try to pop that thing in here today, and the lighting will be a little better. It won't be so dark. I think disconnecting those lines is probably one of the hardest parts of this job, because I didn't want to take the exhaust out. It's too rusty. The rack came right from Nissan. Look at how pretty that thing is. Can't wait to open it up like Christmas. Nissan said give a little shout out to Rain Man Ray, because apparently reusing cotter pins hurts Nissan's soul. They give you a little Ziploc baggie with two new cotter pins. That warms my heart. Making people happy is nice. I think she's in. It's indecent, at least. Not, maybe not 100%, but it's indecent. It's in deep enough and it's in long enough, it's indecent.
Getting this first bolt started is the fun one. Ah, there it goes. Not too bad. Nut goes on top. Rack's not threaded or anything like that.
One more main bolt. Gravity check on aisle 7, please. It's starting early. I don't know what it is, Lola. Look. See what I'm saying? Now the studio's falling apart. The gravity's working like a charm. And all we need is a little cooperation from another bolt and nut. And we'll win. You know what I mean? I think this is gonna be the easy one. Look at that. Oh, you know what? Today's my lucky day. I'm so glad that fell like that. You'll know why I'm happy in a second. If I get this started so the bolt don't fall out first. Get out of the way, hose bracket. The hose bracket and me, we're not getting along right now. There it is. All right, and here's why I'm happy. Look, it tried to get into fluid, but it just missed and it bounced over here. Tell you what, the snap-on light, even at $160 or whatever it was, too expensive, but it's durable as hell. I'm not sure who makes it for them, but I like it. All right, we're getting there now. I'm gonna snug these bolts down. Normally I would put the lines on first, but this has a banjo bolt, so it's pretty easy. It's not like you're trying to line up a hard line, so with the banjo bolt shouldn't be a problem. I'm gonna snug up the mounting bolts first. When you take this rack out of the package, they mark with a blue line where the center is. So you have to put your little blue guide plastic piece in line with that blue mark so that your steering column's close. I mean, luckily on these cars, it's not too hard if you have to move the, if it's off center too much, to get the alignment right. But sway bar is right in the way. It's not as rusty. Getting it off, I had to air hammer it off. Putting it on shouldn't be as bad, but feels like I might have to get some kind of tool. I might have to use my pry bar and force it down once I tighten the rack bolts. I wanted to at least get it started before I did that, but it's lined up. That plastic thing is only a guide. You can bend it, flex it, and put it on off a spline or two. So try to be careful of that. If you take the exhaust out of your way, this is all a lot easier. But like I said, a little rusty, so I don't want to chance it. Even though I recommended replacing this pipe because it rattles if the collars are rusted off the flex shield, the flex coupler, or what do you call that flexible piece? I recommended replacing it, but they declined it, so I'm definitely not going to take it off and risk breaking stuff when they didn't want to spend the money on it. Then they would think I did it on purpose to sell it to them and stuff. You know how that works. In our business, you work on something that's old and rusty, and everything that breaks is your fault kind of thing. I'm trying to avoid that. Sometimes you can't avoid it, but when I can't avoid it, I'm gonna avoid it. It's making this take, I'd probably do it. If I popped the exhaust out of the way and it wasn't rusty, I probably would have done this job like a half hour faster because it'd be way easier to get to the lines and all that stuff. But it's not terrible either way. You guys probably can't see that. Let me get you a better seat. This line. Ah. All right, that's it. That's probably one of the hardest parts of the job because that little clamp, whoo, that thing is like Hercules. That little tiny return hose clamp is probably 10 times stronger than a regular return line hose clamp. I think it's one of those double line squeeze clamps. So, whew, now for the banjo bolt on the pressure line. And two two bracket bolts over here at 10 millimeter.
I got the bolt threaded. Now I gotta pull the line back, make sure my washer didn't fall out of there. Yep, I see a little shoulder of the washer in there. They don't give you new washers with them, so I'm reusing them.
They're pretty thick copper washers, so it's not gonna hurt anything to reuse them.
Get this started, make sure it's in at least a few threads. And then I'm gonna use my impact very gently and to obtain about 12 to 14 foot-pounds. And that should be plenty. Just gotta check it for leaks afterwards, and if it does seep, snug it a little more.
That should be perfect. All these universals and adapters, it's not putting a lot of force in there. So that's a two Ugga-Duggas. That's about 14 foot-pounds for those of you who are new to this. And now it's just those two bolts there. And I'm past all the stuff I was supposed to take the exhaust out for.
The stench is probably a little bit long, huh? Could have went with the 6-inch. But it's more exciting for me this way.
Let's see if we can get this thing down here and show it a little love. Ugh. That's it. Not so bad. One thing too on these, you shouldn't have to force the bolt in. If you're in the right spot, you got it on far enough, it should go right into the little notch on the shaft. And you shouldn't have to fight it. It'll just throw it in by hand a couple turns. Then you grab your trusty Milwaukee impact with your adapter stack. That's about it. Boom. Now, I would normally reuse the old cotter pin just for fun. Really not in bad shape, but I'm gonna put the new ones in since they gave them to us. And I know it'll make Rain Man Ray happy, so that's what I want to do. Like I said earlier, I like when people are happy. I'm not looking to ruffle any feathers, and I definitely don't want to injure someone's soul. If you watch enough of my videos, you know what I'm about to say right here. I'm going to tighten these jam nuts. Ugh. Just, you know, if I run this thing on the alignment machine and one of these wheels is green, and I forget to tighten them up, or I forget that I didn't tighten them up, then it's going to leave with one of them loose, right? So I don't want that to happen. I always tighten them up. I'd rather have to come back and loosen it again. That's fine by me. Much better than leaving one loose. Sway bar links. 19 on the stud, 18 on the nut. Especially with my chubby fingers. Clean this thing off a little bit before I take the cap off. See what kind of power steering fluid this thing takes. They say Nissan or equivalent, probably conventional power steering fluid. All right, let's see if this here Nissan Maxima is like a new car or not. Here goes nothing. Ah, push to start. It's gonna want more fluid. We'll let that stew a little while and work the wheel back and forth and recheck the fluid level a couple. It may take a couple times to get all the air out of it. A lot of times on these too, you have to shut them off, let them sit a few minutes, restart it, that kind of thing. So we'll see how much we have to dance, but we're gonna find a way to make it work like we always do. All right, nice and quiet. Got good power steering. No obvious leaks, nothing terrible. I mean, the fluid's staying in there, right? Of course, I'm gonna check it a little closer when I get it on that alignment rack. I'm gonna pull it all up in there and pull out on the alignment rack.
Skin on with a hint of sea salt and guaranteed to be hot and crispy when you replace them. You know, great for the shipper. Try Wendy's guaranteed hot and crispy bags today.
We're gonna see if we can get that toe, and it's got some negative camber in the right front too. That's no bueno. So I'm gonna set the toe, and then we'll re-sweep the caster and see where we're really at.
That's horrible.
Outdoors Expo, where you can explore sponsor booths.
Uh-oh. Careful. Spidey's. Uh-oh. Spider's gonna get me. Got to reset our steering wheel angle. Get the steering wheel reset, hit reset, and then it zeroes you out. I did it here earlier a second before I grabbed the camera. It was at 2 degrees with the steering wheel straight. So now it's at zero with the steering wheel straight. And that's all it needs, because this has electronically controlled variable steering rate. So you definitely want to make sure you re-zero your steering wheel when you do an alignment. So now it's all set, ready for a drive. See how this Nissan drives. The customer doesn't want to do the camber kit. The credit line's tapped out. No more money. Let's make sure the wheel's straight. So let's see. Steering feels good, no noise. Steering wheel's off a little bit to the left for some reason. That's kind of strange. Look at that. It's off like, three or four degrees to the left from, it's at like 11:45 instead of 12. Just barely off. So I'm gonna have to correct that real quick. She's supposedly coming to get it. I just got back from lunch and I gotta finish it up. So there's no time for lollygagging, whippersnappers. All right, guys. I'm gonna button that up and this car is done. It's gonna be brand new status achieved. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you got something from it. Maybe you got a Nissan Maxima you wanna work on, or you just like seeing what mechanics do on a daily basis. So it's been a pleasure having you here. Make sure you torque that like button down at the bottom of the screen. Give that a torque. And subscribe if you want to see some more automotive related content. I appreciate you guys. I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget, you're awesome.